Hello, and welcome back to Skyward Sword, and this actually isn't where I was expecting to land, but that's a-okay, because it's not like Skyloft super large. It's pretty easy to get back to the market. On the last episode, we dealt with Sandship, and this episode, we're going to go mess around with Eldin Volcano and see if my complaints from super early on about Eldin Volcano that I never really, I guess, mouthed to you guys will become just and true. But more importantly, Skyloft for now. Small quivers, so we'll be able to hold more bow garbage, and once we buy that, we'll be able to upgrade our bow capacity. I am buying your quiver. I am definitely buying your quiver. And I think since I have a full adventure pouch, it'll go back to our fucking Goyle friend. Only 5 extra arrows. Jesus, that's not a lot at all. Definitely going to be trying to... Yep, placing it in our... Oh, it's already gone to our pouch. I guess we'll just... What do we have in our pouch? I guess we had an open thing the entire time and I didn't realize. We can go ahead and talk to Patrice, I believe her name is. That's probably not... saying her name. Yep, here to check you out. I'm pretty sure you've already said that before. I would love to drop something off with you. Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna show it to you. Trust me. It's coming. I'm bringing you the small seed satchel. So I don't really need it anymore. I for some reason thought I was gonna have to motion control down. Why do we have 2 small seed satchels? Maybe we got one out of a thingamajig. I guess we'll take the heart metal. The heart metal makes hearts spawn more often, which probably means that we'll be getting less... money, and I don't particularly want less money. Cursed metal's probably not the best idea. Oh well, whatever. That means I probably shouldn't leave my seed satchel there, but whatever, who cares? We've really, really just wanted to talk to her to advance her story along, because I think, according to what I've read, she's supposed to start calling us darling at some point. Spoilers about the relationship between Lonk and Patrice, the item check girl. Once she starts referring to us as darling, I believe we can move her side quest along. You know what? Actually, we're gonna do some stuff at night, so we'll go ahead and visit her home and see what her and her dad are up to. Those wacky wacky kids. I don't remember if we visit them at night. I know I've went, but I don't remember if that was in the episode that ended up getting scrapped because of the failed recording, or well, the soft lock that had happened. The recording itself did not fail. I suppose that's a bad way to state it. Go ahead and upgrade our bow. More power and can launch arrows farther. That's nice. I figured it'd be one or the other. I didn't think we would be getting both out of that. Upgrading the bow takes tumble, yeah. I wasn't sure if the second form took more tumbleweeds or not, so we're going to have to go gather tumbleweeds before we can upgrade that more monster horn. Do we need monster horns? I'm not too worried about dusk relics and amber, but do we need monster horns to upgrade this? No, we don't, so we're sitting pretty in the city. I can just go ahead and, upgrade it then, because I don't think there was any spillover between Evil Crystal, Lizard Tail, Goddess Plume. Yeah, no spillover. Let's just go ahead and upgrade our quiver. Why the hell not? Yeah, I would love to have more arrows, especially since that small quiver we spent 150 rupees on only allowed us to hold 5 more arrows. Are you kidding me? And I like the idea that it is an additional quiver that your character is carrying around. So Lonk has a main quiver that holds 20 arrows, and he's like, I want to fit more arrows in here. Typically, one would consider just buying a larger quiver, but this game's solution is buying a second, smaller quiver, which is pretty funny. One Goddess Plume. I'm not sure. Does this need just one? Okay, yeah, cool. I think I planned for us to go ahead and purchase this then. So let's go ahead and grab it. Why the hell not? We have money burning a hole in our pocket. That whole 300 rupees, we're loaded. I suppose I should have actually probably checked with what Beetle had before we went in. Because I don't think I've checked in with him since we bought the adventure pouch. So maybe he has something cool there, like maybe a new medal or whatever. I'm not actually completely sure, so we'll just keep rocking it. It's whatever. We'll be rolling in the cash pretty soon anyways. In fact, there's a bunch of goddess chests around on the map. And if I check the map right now, will it give us a map of the bazaar? Or will it give us a map of the sky, I wonder? We can douse our treasure now. I was wondering about that, because last episode I was like, why would we ever need this many dousing things? I guess there's like specific triggers that'll make her go, oh, you can douse for this. Like, I bet if we went to go talk to the potion guy, she'd let us douse for bugs. But let's see, we get a map of the bazaar. The goddess chest. I forgot there was a goddess chest over here, and it looks like it's active. Yeah, it's a goddess chest. We know all about them. Yeah, we've seen a few of these. You know what? This is probably set up so you walk into it first, because it's right here in Skyloft. This is likely to be the first goddess chest you see, and Fi completely explained the mechanic to us right then and there. I don't know if she gave us another explanation about that previously. And, oh, hey, speaking of money, burning a hole in our pocket. Gondo's like grandfather's like fucking secret stash of rupees. We've just dug into them. He was like, yeah, I'll protect it with my goddess chest. No one will go to the land below and activate it. Everything's peachy keen. No problems here. We already talked to him last time about his sleeping problems thanks to his little bundle of joy. I don't think he comes out too much as saying as much. He's just like, oh, I can't sleep. And one can assume this, like, cooking mama ass baby on his back is probably the justification for why he can't sleep, since he seems to be the main child rare. Because his wife is a dedicated businesswoman. She has to cook up all these potions. All her husband does is mix stupid bug guts into it afterwards. He can take care of the baby. She's doing all the hard work here. That probably came off as sarcastic, but I like honestly 100% meant that. Like, she's probably like doing a lot of potion brewing. He's just kind of sitting around and throwing extra potions together. In fact, I think when we talk to him, he's like, oh, I do this because I like this. This is just like a way I can supplement my wife's business and that I enjoy, which is pretty cool. But he is having trouble sleeping because of their babu. So we'll be coming to talk to them tonight. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and just visit Beetle. Why the hell not? Let's see what he has. And I probably shouldn't use an arrow, but hey, screw it. We got an arrow. We're never using the slingshot ever again, unless for some reason there's a context-sensitive thing in the game that Hey. Yeah, stop talking to me, kid. I know how to catch bugs. I'm the best at it. I've caught more bugs than you. How many numbers high can you count to? You're like, what, 4? So you can probably count to like 3? Well, I have 68 Deku Hornets. The largest number ever crafted by man. 68. And yeah, he doesn't really have anything of interest to us. I suppose I could have grabbed that bug metal. Just because I don't know how many things he will restock. Like, he kept restocking the adventure pouches because they were like things that, you know, that there was more of to get. And I'll just go ahead and jump off here. Why the hell not? I don't know if like he'll get new metals in stock and whatnot. Last time we talked to Fledge, he was like, hey, come by at night. I need my fix. I need my good stamina potion energy. I'm just not me without a good hit of my stamina potion. Piper's house. I don't remember who the hell Piper... Oh, Piper's a little kid. I think we walked in there before and his mom was like cooking dinner for him. Once again, don't remember if that was the scrap recording. Everything is all topsy-turvy, especially with me, like, I kind of edit things real lazily. I mark down times for things that, like I have a little timer going, and whenever something happens, I'm like, oh, need to edit that. I normally hit the timer. Sometimes I forget. And then I don't bother to actually listen to my recordings afterwards. I just make sure the audio is fine, pop the videos in sync, make sure it's not out of sync, and I don't watch it through again because I don't have the time for that. That's insane. I don't know how any, like, you know, gameplay editor person has the time to watch through their stuff afterwards. I don't know how they can sit and, like, bear to watch their stuff on top of that. I was just about to say, you know what, I was going to my room to sleep, but we don't have to sleep in our bed, now that I think about it. And actually, I'm going to sleep in Groose's room because this is where Colin will normally... Oh, damn it. I was like, he'll be asleep in the bed. So, like, what happens if we sleep in the bed? But this is a nice little, like, way of, like, justifying, like, why they won't let you sleep in the bed. Because now he'll just hang out in the bed now that we've broken his heart. So we can't sleep in the bed and then all of a sudden he's out of a place. I mean, granted, you probably could have just programmed, like, oh, if you player sleeps in the bed, he doesn't appear. He, you know, put him somewhere else or maybe just make him disappear. But that's honestly probably a better justification. Like, oh yeah, let's make it just so that they can't get to, shoot, I should have slept in Fledge's bed. I just came in here because this was the closest room. Actually, I think Fledge's room might have been closer, but I walked over here without thinking. Whatever. We'll just wake up and Stritch walked in here and he's been staring at his bugs all night. I don't think he even noticed we were here. Bye, Stritch. You didn't see us. We're gone. We're outs. Hey, Fledge. I brought you your good stuff that you probably wanted. Look at him. He's a machine. He's so fast now. Even, like, last time when we saw him, he was kind of, like, dipping a little with his, like, hips. Like, he was struggling. I mean, granted, he was doing 50 push-ups, which if you... I mean, struggling at 50 push-ups? What a wimp! Oh, my good God. He definitely went for the 1,000. Or did we tell him to go to 10,000? I'm pretty sure... Oh, yeah. Like, look at the big beefy boy. A fledgling no more. Fuck, I can't remember the Pokemon that has Fledge. It's Fledgling? No, that's just the name of the bird. Oh, God, I named it Poon Poon. I can't remember what it's called. It's the one from Gen 6. Damn it. It's the one that becomes stupid Talonflame. Ah, what is that bird's name? Damn it. I can't believe I've forgotten a Pokemon's name. Do you think I've gotten enough muscles? What do you think, Lonk? Do I look strong? Too strong, my dude. You're too powerful. No, he appreciates it. He knows we're just kidding with him, because if he was to become too strong would to be surpassed Groose, which would be to surpass what has surpassed humanity, which is surpassing too far. But there we go. We've completed his side quest. We've given him enough the good stuff. I wasn't sure if we would need another potion, so I figured, hey, why not? I'll just go ahead and grab another one, which will activate the second half of, I guess, his dealio. The second half isn't so much as a side quest as he will have an activity for us. Maybe a miniature activity of sorts, a fun one, a game perchance. Is there anything else we need? No. Oh, actually, there is something I want to do here at night that I think we can do. I don't think you're able to do it till you have the claw shots. If you remember, and I hope you guys remember, and I keep referencing the failed recording, but we went and talked to Karen at one point at night, and she was like, oh, yeah, hey, Gravitude Crackle. There are just loose Gravitude Crackles around, like, Skyloft and some of the Beatles Island and, the Lumpy Pumpkin that we can get at night. We're gonna have to go pick those up. We'll probably save that for the minigame episode, just because I don't really care too much. We're going to surpass 40 Gravitude Crackles in this episode. I don't think we'll go to 50. I think there's 80 in the game. I remember looking it up, and I think there's 80, but I don't really remember too well. Are we able to just claw shot up there? Are we gonna have to? Yeah, we're gonna have to go around. Let's see what we can claw shot to. So let's get out of our claw shot, because there's gonna be some ivy over there. I was hoping we'd be able to just claw shot and just call it a day instead of having to climb over, but we'll climb like the peasants we are. But if you remember, Karen was like, yeah, there's someone in the bathroom at night. I really want to take a bath, but, you know, they hog the bathroom all night long. And if you don't remember that, it's because it was in a failed Sawflop recording. The game, like, froze there for a second. That was kind of weird. It was like, oh, shit, what's going on? Yeah. This chimney will take us into the bathroom. El baño. Baño. Not baño. That's, like, a super white way to say it. But I'm a white person. I'm sorry. But we're going to break into El Baño and see who's hogging the bathroom at all hours of the night so Karen can't take a bath. So, I don't know if you've ever broken into a bathroom, but the walls of bathrooms are just loaded with money. Oh! I thought this would actually take us into the bathroom. This is actually Zelda's room that we just broke into. For some reason, Zelda has a little vent that goes straight into the bathroom. Little personal heating, special for the daughter of the headmaster, who seems to be hogging the bathroom all night long. I thought he sang a little song when he did that as well. Don't be a creepo and open this just to see if we... Holy shit, I'm so glad I was a creepo and opened that! Because I was like, when we did this at the beginning of the game, we got a rupee. And I was like, I would enjoy getting a rupee, but there was just a piece of heart in there, which is kind of like a cute little, like, just like, oh, you know, Zelda's your crush you. Your fake crush you, because your real crush you is Pippet. I mean, obviously, Lonkex Pippet is canon in this game, much like Lonkex Maku Tree is canon in every other instance of the game. What happens if we knock on here? Do we get like a, hey, I'm in here, go away? Nope, he doesn't even acknowledge it. He's like, my students need to bathe, but I am the dirtiest headmaster of all. I need to bathe for 8 hours straight. From dusk till dawn will I bathe. My students will be smelly, but I will be the soap-laddened headmaster of Skyloft Night Academy, the cleanest of them all! And that's enough of that. What else do we need to do here? We needed to go visit, oh, wait, is that someone who's out, or... Oh, no, that was a lamp. That was not a human being. My bad. That's a very easy mistake to make. And oh, you know what? Since we've never done it, I'm gonna go ahead and just... Here we go. This is the good, good shit. I spent a good long while doing this the first time I played Skyward Sword, and we're just gonna walk around with a little pumpkin sword. Because these enemies, they can't even touch us. You are nothing to me. Absolutely nothing, you, like, Avatar the Last Airbender-ass, like, lemur. Whose house are we going to? We're going to the potion people's house. I don't remember which one they are. Birdie's house. Oh, that's interesting that they refer to it as Birdie's house. They don't mention his wife, even though, like, you know, his wife is very clearly, like, the breadwinner of the family. Yeah, if we come over here, we can see that she's passed out. Like, I get that she's doing all the like, super important businessy stuff, but she should probably be doing a little bit more help with the child rearing, because, like, they're both going to work. It's not like he's a stay-at-home dad or anything. He could very much use the help. Like, look at that, like, cooking-ass, like, cooking-ass bait. Almost a cooking-ass baby mama, which, an interesting statement on its own, but the cooking mama-ass baby. Are you tired? Oh, I thought he was gonna be like, eh, like the Bean Man from Majora's Mask and Ocarina of Time. He makes the good ehs. I thought they were just gonna, like, use that ah, but he was just kind of like, yeah, I'm really fucking tired, my dude, because he hasn't slept. It was before we lost the you-know-what. Oh, that? Yes, the baby's rattle. That's good. I thought he wasn't actually gonna tell us. I remembered it was a rattle. A bird picked it up and flew off with it. Maybe the bird thought it was food. What was a dumbass bird? Oh, what's this, like, child maraca? I bet I can eat this. Okay, so a bird carried it away, but he believes it to still be in town. So when he says bird... Oh, okay, never mind. I guess they have crows here as well. Or, guays, excuse me. They have guays above the sky. So I was about to say, too, they only have loft wings up here, as they freaked out about... Or Groose, specifically, freaked out about the small bird. Wait, what? Oh, Pippet! Yeah, Pippet, I forgot him. Pippet will get pissed at his mom if you walk by their house after you've cleaned the house for her. Yeah, you've been giving someone rupees to clean the house. He knew that the house was too clean for that. Yeah, see, it's such a shame. They are, like, I guess they are kind of like a poor family. That's super, super sad. You know, he gave her money to buy bread, and she spent it on cleaning. Yeah, I'm sorry for barging in my... Nope. What? What did you say? I couldn't even hear what you said now, let alone you and your mom arguing. What more of you just demolishing your own mother, my guy? I didn't hear any of that. Oh, awkward. Karen dodged a bullet with him. She dodged a bullet, and we took it for ourselves. Just lodged that bullet right in our, like, where you shoot bullets into people holes. Oh, I guess we'll just go ahead and accept this gravitude crackle. I didn't mean to be doing a lot of, like, hunting on Skyloft, but I guess that's where we are in our this point in our life. Oh shoot, we have 40 as is. You know what? Screw Birdie. We don't need to help him at all. We got what we came for. Is this going to be close enough? No, we might have to go to the other side. So, I think once again, not sure if this was in the scrapped recording due to the soft lock, but that island, I kept trying to jump on it, like, oh, hey, I think we can jump on that island, because there's no physical way up there normally. But I believe what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to claw shot up there. So I came and took a look at it, and I remember seeing some vines on it, but I can't remember where they are, because... am I not a good at recording on a daily basis like I probably should be, boy. But this game is getting done before the third. And as of now, I have less than a week remaining to finish this game. I took a look at how I think the episodes are going to be split, and I think it's going to work out. But for all I know, this could go very south very quickly. Let's just get these keys out of our way. We have visual of some ivy. Maybe I'm incorrect, and this isn't how we're supposed to get up there. Because I thought there was just some ivy hanging from that, and we could just rock it up there. And, oh, is that a goddess chest? Yeah, that's a goddess chest. I don't see how to get over there. Maybe once if we got up there, we could do the damn thing. Unfortunately, we are not up there yet. We are very far away from up there. Let's get to the top of the water, and let's see first person and look around. I don't see any ivy. I thought you're supposed to be able to claw shot up there. Perhaps we are supposed to jump up there. I do want to finish this birdie quest just because we've kind of started it. But we're also I wanted to do all of Eldin in this episode, so this episode could become quite the doozy. Go away, enemies. I don't want to mess with you. Well, we looked at these sides. Perhaps we'll be able to see it from the most backmost. That's good word use. Shoot, maybe this would be easier if I made it daytime, but I don't particularly want to make it daytime again. You know, let's go ahead and make it day after we go visit Batru, so we can go ahead and get our upgrade. I'm not too desperate for upgrades, which is why I'm not bothering to go and get the goddess chest that we have available. Because, you know, I figure we'll just go pick those up once we have all the goddess chests we're probably going to grab in the game, because we have, like, all the adventure pouches. All that could potentially be left are really, like, rupees, I guess additional medals, if there are any out there, and pieces of heart. But I'm feeling pretty good about the amount of health we have. I'm not too worried about upping our health dramatically. I would much rather just kind of do side quests for just the joy of completing stuff, whatever. No, just a gold rupee, really. I was hoping for a wallet upgrade again, but I guess we're good. Oh, what are you going to allow us to? Oh, she's probably going to allow us to douse for gratitude crackles. I wonder if this is just for solitude gratitude crackles, or if this is, like, if it would help you douse for side quests. I'm guessing. Why do I? Oh, damn it. My stupid tissue box fell over and some of the tissues fell on the floor. How did I not notice that till now? Well, that sucks. Because those tissues are now dead to me. Putting tissues on the floor up to my nosy hole, that's just gonna upset my allergies, I think. I'm kind of a little bit of a germaphobe. So there's that. Those tissues are dead to me, unfortunately. The rest of the tissue box, I'm just gonna move it. There we go. Picked it back up so no more tissues fall to the tyranny of that. Let's go ahead and just shift it today so I can see. And is this a... Oh, it's Pippet's house. We're just gonna go ahead and sleep in Pippet's house? Hey, Pippet's... Wait, how did he realize that you paid someone to clean your house? Your house is a wreck again. Did he walk in here and went, ooh, you cleaned this at some point. You must have paid someone. You cleaned really good at some point. That's unlike you. How? But, like, the state it's in, like, oh, you know what? Actually, I'm thinking about it in a dumb roundabout way that he noticed that the house was too clean. Like, obviously, he saw, wait, where's the bread? And then she went, oh, I didn't buy it. And he was like, well, where's the money? And she's like, I don't have that either. That 20 rupees, that king's fortune is gone. I've spent it on cleaning services. Shoot, I thought we were supposed to be able to claw shot. Oh, there it is. There's a different island over there, and I bet we can just claw shot our way up vis-a-vis other islands. And actually, can I hop up on here? Yeah, let's go ahead and just dig over here. Why the hell not? See. Okay, Wiimote, you please play ball with me. It's looking like this is going to be a doozy of an episode because nothing... Oh, we're about to go off the side. There we go. Cool. I meant to do that. I'm very good at this game. 20 rupees, 25 rupees, 30 rupees, 35 rupees, 35 rupees. Okay, whatever. I'm not, like I said, money's not too big of a concern. We're not worried about running out of rupees either, so I mean, I guess we'll just go ahead and... Or running out of rupees, running out of wallet space, I meant, because we have like a 1900 large... Oh, I wanted to see if I could jump up there. A 1900, like, large rupee. Hell yeah, I'm the best at this game ever. No one's better at this video game than I am. Put my name on the number one speedrunning list just because I'm so skilled at playing this video game that I couldn't see this island that I knew was here because I remember looking around and going, oh, wait, is that goddess just active? That goddess just active, wait. Oh, shoot, how long has that been on our map and I didn't notice? Oh, well, I guess we'll be going to grab that as well because we can totally just jump off this island to go and get it. Which is actually probably a good thing that we made it night then, because I bet if I tried to jump off, it would have activated the stupid thingamajig that dumb happens. Oh, there's another goddess chest up here, and there's bubber flies, which will probably make a gossip stone appear. Oh, actually, shoot, I thought the rattle was up here, but I remember now that there's a crow's nest on top of, like, the windmill that we can... What the hell is that? Oh, it's a goddess bloom. Nice. I kind of wish he had given us a tumbleweed. I mean, there was no way he was ever going to give us a tumbleweed. But, you know, I'll accept this. I'm not too worried about collecting this goddess chest right now, but I know if I don't do it, I'll just forget it exists. So I should... Oh, I don't want to do that. Because if I fall off that way, then I'm definitely not going to, A, make it, and B, also activate the stupid knights coming to save me cutscene. And, oh, please, no, Wiimote, what are you doing? That was the wrong way! Wait, no, shit, I shouldn't have called my bird. Damn it! I was actually going to cut there, but that was probably a useful thing to show, that if you jump there, it just transitions you down here. You can't actually physically jump to that island. Because once again, not sure if that was in the scrapped recording or not. So there's that. We probably can't make this jump. I'll just go ahead and take the time to go up here, make the jump, then we'll come back over here, go back up here again, and jump for the rattle. Because I think we have to come up here to be able to jump for the rattle. Because if we, I guess, just walk over here, we can see that's where we want to land. I think if we jump off here, we might be able to, I was going to say transition down there, but we're going to, like, fall. I think we'll be able to fall down there properly, and this has to be it, because there's a little jumpy off spot. Okay, cool. Wiimote, work with me. There we go. I'll just hold B so I don't, like, screw it up with the motion control. I hope this is something cool. Like, just give me, like, hey, this is, like, the make the game, like, even more interesting. No, nope, that's absolutely not what I wanted. Not at all. Shit. Hey, there was vines there. Oh, hey, there was the little platform where we saw our bird, where our bird was captured, I think. And I'm just gonna go ahead and just dive down, and boy, this lets you go down farther than I thought the game would let you go. Because I thought eventually I thought eventually we would hit the point where a knight would save us, which would be quicker than trying to transition back into the screen by getting on a bird, falling, blah, 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 blah. Whatever. Yep, sharpen up or you'll never make knighthood. Dude, I'm already a knight, I think. I did the wing ceremony. I think that was to become a knight. I think I'm a knight. Get off my back. And even if I'm not, like, who's going to tell me no? I have, like, the super double-powered goddess sword. I got, like, two pieces of the Triforce. Maybe just it's showing that I'm qualified to handle the Triforce. Typically when they show the thing on the hand, though, that's like the, you've got the Triforce in you, my dude. You've been infected with Triforce. It's terminal. You will at some point in your life now perish before you would have lived forever. And oh yeah, we can totally make this if the game won't. Boom! Yeah, first try. I'm so good at this video game. How do I get this out? Oh, we have to like give a little blow away the dirt. Yeah, I thought we had to like dig it out, but nope. There we go. The baby's rattle. It's kind of an interesting rattle. It has kind of a cylindrical shape to it. And oh my god, I just looked at the recording. We're 30 minutes in and we haven't left Skyloft. Oh my good god, this episode's about to be a hot mess. A hot, hot mess. Especially, because my complaint with Eldin Volcano is about to become super, super apparent with this area. If we have to do what I think we have to do, I'm gonna go ahead and sleep in Birdie's bed. And actually, wait, look, we can't get to Birdie's wife's bed, who I'm unsure of her name. Except we haven't really talked to her. I suppose we could lock on to her at night and have Fi tell us her name. I'm not sure if that's creepy or not, but I kind of want to do it so I don't have to call her like the potion making lady. Let's see. Can we lock on to her? Yep. What's her name? Oh, her name's Love. That's very, very cute. They're Birdie and Love. That's very nice. She's in charge of Say. Oh, wait. Hold up. Wait. Actually, that kind of gave us a little bit more of a... Let's see what their relationship was. A big proponent of eating and sleeping. She runs the potion shop with her husband. She mixes and infuses the potion. She's in charge of... Okay, so she creates the potion. And what about Birdie? Birdie. House husband and businessman responsible for infusing... Okay, so they both do infusing potions. I guess maybe the sales portion... I almost said the sales potion. Yep, we found the rattle. You guys maybe need to talk about your relationship and making it a little bit more even. Because you seem to be putting a little bit more effort into it at the moment, my guy. Oh boy, oh boy. Yep, the baby seemed to settle down. You gave it a thing. It can shake around and make a lot of noise, and now you can definitely sleep for sure. Well, he didn't think about the kind of, I guess, logical fallacy there, but he was gracious, so, you know, whatever. We have his stupid gravitude crystals. He's already become... He can't take them back. He's already gracious to us. What up, my guy? I'm gone. I'm sleeping in your bed till morning. He was so happy to be able to get a night's sleep. But then, like, here's the rattle. Oh, thank God I can sleep. And then the stupid teenager who just helped you jumps in your bed and passes out and does not wake up until the morning. Like, you guys are gone. You have to leave your door unlocked so he can get... Well, I suppose you can lock the door and then he could lock it. I guess everyone just leaves their doors unlocked on Skyloft for the most part, except for really, like, what doors are locked in Skyloft? There's Zelda's room. There's the fake door that leads to that area with the goddess chest and the actual treasure chest that you have to take the, like, the water tunnel. Boy, there's probably a better way to say water tunnel. It's not a canal. The water tunnel. You have to take the water tunnel you have to swim through to get to, like... Like, I know that's not a real door, but it's essentially supposed to be, like, a locked door in-universe, I'm assuming. I know, actually, there's a speed gate there. I should probably go hit that instead of doing what I normally do to get speed, where I just fly super high and then just dive bomb until my wings refill, and then I start flying high again. But luckily, we'll just be able to kind of just barely not make it into the stupid speed gate. Like, yep, like, I was trying to think of, like, how to correct it. Like, I tried to flap it, but then, like, the bird was like, you want me to go down? I was like, no, I'm trying to flap so you go up. And bird's like, oh, down. I'm very acquainted with your direction. Down. Oh, you wanted me to go into the stupid thing. I'm sorry, Master Lonk. I didn't mean to make you look like a fool in front of the whole, like, 10 people who will watch this video. You idiot bird. Oh, shoot, I actually just realized I don't know where we should be going. Where do we do gravitude crackle collecting? Oh, let's just fall to Volcano Entry. And then from here, we'll, I think Volcano Entry is the first one. It might be Volcano East. I'm not 100% sure. I'm just assuming Volcano Entry is the entrance to the area. We can come down here, we'll douse and figure out where we need to go. And oh, hey, I see Gorko. Yep, Eldin Volcano. Mm-hmm. Dowsing ability, very aware of how that works. Very uncomfortably aware. What's up, Gorko, my guy? My dude, what are you doing today? Yeah, I've been doing great. How you been doing, bud? Goddess cubes. Oh, I get the feeling there's some more hidden away. Yeah, I love finding the goddess cubes. Yep, I'm gonna find them as well. Oh, shoot, and this is gonna let us douse for goddess cubes. I guess that's useful, because now we can, I guess, just point around and see if there's actually a goddess cube. I've taken the liberty of registering that. Thanks, hi. Okay, so I guess that's the point that they let us start dowsing for, I guess, miscellanea once we power up. We just have to activate it. It just seemed a little weird, because it was like, you know, we've only ever had, like, maybe two dowsing targets available at any given time. So it just seemed a bit strange to suddenly be like, you can douse for 7 things! It's insane! Speaking of dowsing, let's go ahead and start dowsing, because I have no idea where this trial gate is off the top of my head. I don't know why I kept going. Like, we saw that it was in this direction. And you know what? I wanted to, like, try and get a read on where it would be, and then I was thinking, oh, we'll just fly to a closer thing. But I have no idea where this is in the long run. It is, like, right over there. Can we... No, we don't have a good way of getting down there, unfortunately. Do we have a good way of getting over there? Nope. We're gonna have to traverse Eldin Volcano, which is really, like, my kind of big complaint with Eldin Volcano. I think Eldin Volcano's a well-crafted area. I don't think it's... Oh, I don't think I'm gonna make it to that lava, so let's just go ahead and kill these keys. So they don't get the better of us while the lava is risen? Boy, this stays up for a long time. Either that or it's already... No. There's no way it cycled that quickly with how long it was up. It's just that lava stays up for much longer than you would expect. This is where some magma live. Let me make sure that this isn't where we're supposed to be. Nope. We're continuing on that way? Yep, it's flipping this way. Oh, that's not an exit. So I suppose we'll just continue out this way. I thought that might have been an exit. The problem I have with Eldin Volcano is it's very, it's like a big sprawling area, which is very nice, but coming and exploring it multiple times kind of becomes a hassle, because, like, look at, Lineru Desert. It has that big, like, center deserty, yes, it has a big center deserty thing, but it has that big center area that makes kind of traversing it pretty simple for the most part. This area is super sprawled out, and kind of traversing it can be a pain. Like, I just want to get across this little gap of fire, and there's not, like, a real good way of doing it that I can see. Like, we have ways of getting over there. Maybe if we just loop back around here, this will take us over here, because remember, we destroyed a wall. I don't know, so it's just we're going to be exploring this area a lot. Especially in this episode, and I can see the butterflies. Cool, cool, cool. Let's go ahead and hop into the Silent Realm if I can do the stupid thing that we're supposed to do. So yeah, it's just going to become a pain, because, you know, we're going to have to explore right now to do the Silent Realm stuff. And then after we come out, I think we have to explore just this area again. I don't know if there's another area that we're going to be going to now. Maybe what I'm thinking of is later. In fact, yeah, I think what I'm thinking of doesn't happen till later in the game when we come back here to explore again, because spoilers, we're going to be coming back to this area again, just like we do with everything. I think you go back to every area like 3 times, I think? I think 3 is the magic number of times you go back to every area. Oh man, I just had it. I think we actually get to see a new area while exploring this for now, which is nice. So maybe my complaints won't be too open. I guess we'll see how the Silent Realm goes. Because in the Silent Realm, they kind of have a chance to redesign the area a little bit. And am I just constantly losing that one and respawning that same petal over again? Because I can't get the stupid rhythm down. I need to be coming out when it goes in and in when it goes out. You're kind of, I guess, oppose the rainbow. Oppose the rainbow, and my new Skittle slogan I've been working on. It's really funny. So often while I'm doing this, I think, oh shoot, I'm losing frames because of the weird digitized nature of Fi's voice. But I kept an eye on the frame counter that entire time, and it was a solid... Oh my god, that harp playing sounds really bad. God, I hate the stupid harp. The harp is such a bad, not great, not good, bad mechanic. Like I said last time, obviously it works and functions, just not well. And let's say even the motion control did work. Like it worked as intended, and please just put the thing in. I actually swung the Wiimote like the wrong way to get that done. Oh my god, just, you know, if it wasn't a battle with the motion controls, even then it's like, oh, I'm just, let's say the motion controls were perfect. I'm just waving my arm back and forth in rhythm, not doing anything real special with it. And oh, I thought that was a plume of waking water. That'll be interesting, kind of exploring that, slope with waking water to kind of act as a barrier. Oh yeah, and the tears are red. That's interesting. Yeah, I didn't even think about that. I don't know why I was so enamored by the red tears, but yep. Din Silent Realm, a test of our power. Our ability to power through this huge freaking area. Yep, achieve spiritual growth. Yep. Give me the spirit vessel so I can go and go fill it with the goddess tears. I think I was also not complaining, but kind of confused about the basis of the three goddesses and the story in addition to the goddess. And I think it might get explained in the story. I saw a little tidbit that made me think that there's a little thing going on. Oop, my game kind of lagged for a second there whenever we came out of our safe zone. That is actually a thing I like, that you're not safe when you initially start. Like, we have no safety. Like, we have the flower. I kind of wish you didn't have the flower, because for a second I was like, oh, when we leave, we'll be safe for a little bit, because, you know, we have the flower. But when you start, you don't have any safe time. You're immediately thrown into danger zone. And I don't know why I came back for that desk relic. I don't think we really needed it, but oh well. Pick it up, why not? We'll go ahead and just refresh the bad stuff. I see a, yeah, we're gonna just go ahead and juke this dude and take his tier so we can get some safe time going. I do like that you don't start with safe time, so it's immediately, like, once you leave the Silent Realm, it's on. It's time to go. You're not safe. I do wish, however, that it was maybe signposted a little bit better that you're not going to be safe when you leave, because, like, oop, that's straight into the magma. Lava, I don't care. I think lava's when it's out, magma's when it's in, and this is out at the moment, so it's lava. Who cares? Even if I'm wrong and I'm backwards, I'm not going to Google it and correct myself. And, oh, that's why we didn't land on anything. There's nothing down there. I think magma's N, so I'm just gonna roll with that. You know, let's go for the... Or we can just burn our butt again. Oh, that's cool. Our spirit kind of fades when we do that. That's nice. I think that might be also what happens when we get attacked by the guardians. I think that maybe we just, they attack us, we pop and head back to the start of the area, I believe. That's just kind of me just winging it, because we haven't been attacked by a guardian. And I don't even know if I've ever, like, failed in these areas, because they're not, like, super difficult. They are very fun, though. I very much so enjoy these areas where they let you kind of retread ground that you're familiar with at that point. And oh, shoot, this is probably a bad idea to come over this way, because we're going to have to come down here when we do the stupid slide. I forgot the word slide for a second there. Yeah, and this is going to take us up to the slide, so whoops, we didn't really need to explore down there just yet. Oh, and that's funny. He went up, but he didn't pull out his... Yeah, because we don't have our sailcloth in this area. but he still puts his hands up like he's doing the animation for the sailcloth. That was very, very interesting. Is this still going to burn us? Because in the real world, this is like Bad Zone City because it's super hot. Not the video game, just it's a volcano and super hot. But here in the Silent Realm, it's cool. It looks warm, but it is in fact cool. This is probably going to be... Oh, yeah. I was using the motion control, which was, you know, admirable of me to try. But no motion control here. This is just cool gameplay, and I don't see any pillars of light off in that direction, so we're going to... Oh, yeah, cool. I forgot that we can kind of run for a little bit here, which allowed me to actually get over that little jettison that would have stopped us otherwise. Is there going to be a tear of light in the... No tears of light in the offshoot here. So I guess we'll just hurry back onto the slide. Do the... shoot, the fruit doesn't respawn. I thought the fruit might respawn. So let's go ahead and just, I guess, grab this one. Or maybe the fruit was there and the fruit does respawn. I'm not sure. It would kind of suck if the fruit didn't respawn, because it would make it difficult to kind of find where stuff is, since you only have, basically, a limited amount of time that you can explore here safely, without, you know, in the safe time, since you'll eventually, you know, run out of time, and the guardians will be upon you. But with the fruit respawning, that gives you a chance to kind of do a little bit of extra exploring that you would have potentially missed out on. And is this all just Bad Zone? No, just from the angle, it looked like all Bad Zone. I think where that last pillar is in... Oop, am I going to be able to run off this? Nope, I am not. That's fine, though, because I see... I thought I was going to just slip and slide into the stupid waking water. And I think this is just over here. Maybe I was incorrect, but I think it's just over here. Yeah, cool, it's right here. And I don't think we need to go on the slide anymore. I thought they were going to be super mean and put a ton of these tiers of light on the slide. What the heck was I saying? Oh, yes, since you have a limited amount of time, since there's only so many tiers in the area, and no way to regen safe time without picking up a tier, it'd be really mean if the Fruit of Light, which I believe it's called, that makes the pillars on the tiers appear, if those didn't respawn, it'd be very mean, because then it's like all of a sudden you have no way of, like, oh, where are the tiers at a glance? So you can't just kind of... if I were to run out, I would just have to... It'd become all panic mode while I run from, you know, run here to try and figure out where stuff is, where I haven't been, maybe consulting the map, which could be bad times for somebody. So by just letting the fruits respawn, it's probably a little bit better, because even if it's going to be super hectic, because it's going to be hectic regardless of what you do, it's nice that they have that consideration of, let's at least let the, oh, cool, I thought he was gonna get me. Do we need to go down there? Yeah, we need to go down there. We're just, like, super just out of that dude's range. That's funny. We'll just come down here. And it's funny, they actually replace, like, all of the stamina fruit that they put on the, on this climb up with, oh, no, there is one stamina fruit. Okay, I was gonna say, I thought they got rid of all the stamina fruit for, the fruit of light, or light fruit, whatever the hell they call it. I don't really care. The good help you see things fruit. It is nice that they had that one stamina fruit there, so you could kind of make that mad dash. And what's up, my guy? Nothing hidden behind him. I thought they'd put a dusk relic behind there, because that seems like a good prime location for a dusk relic. Not that we really need them, I guess. Oh, speaking of not really needing them, I forgot Thrill Digger was here. Maybe that's what happened, that I just, you know, I found Thrill Digger the first time and then never thought to come back here. Oh, damn, we came all the way up here, and there's no loop around, because we can't destroy these things. We don't have access to any of our items, so we're actually just going to have to slip and slide down here without getting hit by any of those guys, which I immediately jump into them. I looked up their enemy names, and those guys aren't referred to as Poes. They're called, like, Sky Watchers and Earth Watchers, I believe, which is kind of lame. I kind of wish they were, like, you know, Poes, if they were, like, you know, like, Vigilant Poe or, you know, something like that. Like, obviously that wasn't the best name, but it was just what I came up with off the cuff there. And we need to head over into that area. But is there a good way to get over there? Because we can't make this jump. What do you got to say, my guardian friend? Because I don't really know a good way over there, as it were. Perhaps we do have to go this way. That's cool. The music doesn't stop when we were in the... maybe it was trying to fade into the safe track while we were down there. But the music didn't stop, because we were not safe. We were just not momentarily being hunted. Is there a way down? Oh, okay, I see a way down from here. So I'm just going to make the jump, and I didn't make it. Nice. But we did find the way that connects. And, oh, the guardian's just right there. Let's get out of there before he, like, slices our head off or whatever the hell he does. I doubt he'll slice our head off, but it kind of has, like, a Scissor Man or whatever the guy from Clock Tower, like the bad guy. He kind of has that vibe going on with the dual blades and the kind of snippy noises. That's what he's making me think of. Which made me immediately think, yeah, he's just gonna slice her head off if we get caught, you know. NBD, you know, getting your head cut off in a Legend of Zelda game, it's whatev. That was a nice placement for that tier, because that was getting a little close for comfort. We'll wait for that Poe. I don't give a crap. I don't know why I stuttered there, because I was gonna be like, I don't give a shit, but then the word crap came out, and then I was just kind of confused. But I don't know. I don't care if they're... The hell? Oh, that's the lava. I was like, what the hell is that in the lava? But that's the little hole that we bombed. I don't really care if they're watchers. They're Poes. They have, like, a Poe-like design with, like, the little lamp. And I guess the noise they make isn't really associated with Poes. But they make that good, good noise. And, you know, that doesn't help my argument at all. But I'm going to continue referring to them as Poes. And no one can stop me except for myself. Which, you know, I was apparently able to make myself stop saying shit. Even though I was like, oh, yeah, you know, I don't give a shit. And then just I stuttered and crap. That probably wasn't the best sentence, but you guys understood what I meant, and that was all, that's all that matters in the long run. I guess we'll come back for that tier of light, because I doubt this is going to loop around in a convenient way. What is this down here? Oh, it's a gate! I was like, is that, like, just a shit ton of goddess plumes? But no, it was not. It was just a little gate to stop us from continuing on in that direction. We're sitting pretty good with our time. We have maybe, 20 seconds left? There's no way connecting back here. I see a tier of light, though. We'll see if we can go ahead and grab that before we run out of time. And even if we do, the guardians aren't, like, the fastest. So I doubt they'd be able to catch up to us, especially since there isn't a flying one around. So we're doing pretty good, especially... Oh, hey, what are you doing? I was holding the Wiimote, like, the op... Oh, that's the... I was like, what the hell is that noise? That may... Like, I'm holding the Wiimote in the other direction, and he's just like, nope, I'm falling off, I'm tilting it the other way, game! Oh my god. Now we have to wait for the stupid guardians, and we're on a tightrope. This isn't great. This isn't great at all. It is only that Earth one, and I don't think he'll be able to get over here, unless he runs through lava, which would be super cool. But we're right here. We're super safe. It's just, why is the motion control, like, being such a, like, it's just like, oh, yeah, you're not doing it. You're pointing it the wrong way, and it's like, dude! I'm working with you here. I'm doing exactly what I should. Why is Locke still falling? God, I wish the motion control was better in this game, because this game could be super slick if it was good. But it's just not all there. And, oh, hey, there was just an easily accessible tier of light, so we kind of made that unnecessarily stressful. It wasn't too bad, though, I suppose, in the end. Last two tiers. We have that one that I missed the swing on, so I guess we'll just head back that way. I don't think, like, this Silent Realm segment has completely validated my complaints with this area. Like, I think it's a little bit apparent that this area is kind of annoying to explore. And I saw a Dusk Relic up there. I just want to see if I can knock it down. It does not seem that this is a tree we can roll into and knock it down. Perhaps we can climb up there and grab it. Or we just got to hit it from a different angle. Cool, cool, cool. And we'll just stay on the top this time instead of falling off. We'll come back for that last tier of light after we get the slightly more accessible one. I don't know, this area is just kind of a pain to explore. Because, like, as you've seen, it's like real sprawled out in weird ways. There's a lot of choke points that you have to, like, adventure through, which kind of makes it maybe not the best area to have to re-explore. But just like every other area in the game, we have to re-explore it several times. Because that's how this is what this game does. And I don't think having to re-explore the areas is a bad thing. I like the area design here, or in this game. Like, I think it's real good, and, even the ways that they reuse it aren't, like, bad. Like, I think this area just wasn't really designed very well with the thought of having to explore it multiple times. I think that's really the only downside of Eldin Volcano, which is kind of a serious downside when you consider we're going to have to come and re-explore, like, this first, like, little volcano-y segment 3 times throughout the course of the game, this being considered our second time, not Not even counting having to go and look for, like, the pinwheel or any other, like, side quests. Because, like, you know, the pinwheel is pretty easy to find. So I'm just not even going to go, please get back on the real part of the bone instead of doing all these fancy, like, parkour tricks, Lonk. That was very scary. I don't want to get caught, because if we get caught here, that'll be, that would have been bad. I mean, I suppose there's not a whole lot of pose in this area aside from the, aside from that, incline, not the one that we typically slide down, but the one that we ran up. There were a lot of pose over there, but for the rest of the area, it was pretty chill, which is kind of a nice consideration because of how sprawled out this area is. If you get caught in an area where you don't have any tiers, it could have been a real pain to get another one or become safe, or whatever. And the, by having less pose around, then once you completed all the tiers, it's less likely that you're going to get caught and then have to make a mad, mad dash for the beginning of it, the area. But whatever. So far, that's been my least favorite Silent Realm, but I still enjoy the Silent Realms as a concept, like making you re-explore and using your knowledge of areas that you've been to before. I didn't commit this area super well to memory, just because it's kind of sprawling out in a weird way. It sprawls out a lot. You know, I made my complaints about that, like, pretty apparent. Am I full up on bombs? Yep, I can only carry 15 still. So yeah, this area is kind of, I guess, a bit more challenging because it wasn't as easy to memorize as the stupid place we were before, the desert. I couldn't remember what it was called, but it wasn't as easy to memorize as, like, the desert or Farron Woods, which are pretty simple to keep together in my head. And I believe this is the hot area we couldn't previously really traverse because we'd come in here and it would hurt us. But our new earrings keep us safe. Varia suit? We don't need full body protection. We just need some earrings to keep us nice and cool. And actually, can we see the? I don't know if there's a good way to get super close to Link's model. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, the earrings even appear on his model, which is super nice. I wonder if the water dragon scales somewhere on his model as well. The earrings even flash whenever we go into an area we can really explore. Which really, these earrings are just kind of the key to the lock that is this area. Because there's no really other hot areas in the game. Like, there wasn't, like, a super hot area in the woods. There's not a super hot area in the volcano or in the sky anywhere that we could have seen previously. So these earrings are really just a key for this area, which isn't particularly great. Like, The Legend of Zelda is not super good about these kinds of things. 90% shim? There's fire everywhere, at the very least. So I guess we'll see if there's sacred flames here as well. And with that, we've unlocked the entire area of the volcano. Like, we still have one area to go with Lineru, but this is the last area of the volcano, at the very least. With the fire shield earrings, they're really just a key to get into here. Like, we didn't see this earlier in the game, but this is the only, like, locked-off hot area we can get to. Like, I mean, you could argue that maybe, like, the next temple required it, but it's not like we could have seen the next temple earlier in the game. Like, we can see this. Like, we can walk up here and the game goes, it's too hot to continue, turn around, and that's that. So they're really, these earrings are just a lock for the key that was that door back there. And Legend of Zelda series has never been particularly great at this. Like, Ocarina of Time has the same problem with literally the same setup, like the fire tunic for the... Oh, did it put us out? Because it activated. Our earrings activated. I don't know if that put us out or if I just happened to roll at the same time that it went off. Who knows? The fire volcano-y place, fire temple and the volcano and Ocarina of Time kind of have the same problem going for it. Like, there's no hot areas in the game aside from that, so the fire tunic's really just a lock to the key that is that temple in the volcano section, which isn't particularly great. Like, it could be used in more interesting ways to make you backtrack. Like, the Varia suit from Metroid. I was gonna say Super Metroid, but I think the Varia suit's in probably a little bit more games than that, just that one. I don't even know where the hell we're supposed to be going. Like, that was an exit over there. That's where it was. That's probably the entrance into, like, the temple, since it's wooden. Oh, that's also an exit. I thought that was a thing. Interesting. Oh, shoot, this actually might be the temple instead. Well, let's see what Gorko has to say. Yep, looking for goddess cubes. Yep. Okay, so he can't just walk through the fire like the Goron and Majora's Mask, where you can just kind of trudge through lava and there's, like, no problems whatsoever. You want bomb? You want bomb? He no want bomb. I'll take my bomb back, thank you. Maybe we whip the tongue? Maybe we have to do something that we don't have yet. Maybe I shoot it with an arrow. Oh, quench my thirst, we need to bring him water. Okay, that makes a lot more sense. So like, shoot it with an arrow? That's kind of real visceral, like, kind of tugging on the tongue to make him go, bleh, you know, that's kind of cartoony, and oops, I thought I could run around you. That's fine. I probably could have just stayed on fire to see if my fire shield earrings work, but whatever. So we just need to bring this water over? I thought there'd be a bigger puzzle to it. I suppose not. I would like to go and explore that other area before we continued onwards, but what I'm guessing is there's probably some kind of lock over there stopping us from getting into where I assume the temple is. And what's the deal with this area? What is going on here? I see vines down there. I see vines over there. Can I claw shot them? Let's see if there's like maybe a little hidden secret over here. I bet it's like just a goddess cube or something. Well, I mean, I say just a goddess cube, but goddess cubes are pretty helpful. Pretty helpful. They're good rewards. And, you know, it's fun. You explore, you find a thing. It's nice. Maybe I'm supposed to dive off of here, land on the ivy, or not, or we could just not land on the ivy. I saw the goddess cube at the very least. I might even be able just to dive straight to that goddess cube. If I could have jumped onto the ivy. Please don't do a Superman dive, because now we're just going to die because we're too far below. Thanks a lot for that one, motion control. Yeah, because I think we would actually be able to make the jump over to just the goddess just for it's a cube, whatever, who cares, we made it. And from here, we can explore the rest of the area. Yeah, you know what, we probably had to dive here, because there's no way to hookshot over here. Even if I had gotten on the vines, we couldn't turn around, claw shot back on over here. And I know I'm using the phrase claw shot and hook shot like interchangeably. You're going to have to excuse me. Claw shots have been a thing in the series long enough that they've also integrated into my vocabulary, but it's like the hook shot will like never be replaced in my vocabulary as well, so it's just you're gonna get this like Frankenstein amalgam of me referring to it as the hook shot, the claw shot, in differing times. And is there something else we can hookshot onto? Oh yeah, there's more ivy over there. Let's just continue onwards before we run out of stamina and fall to our doom. Oh, cool. We can chill like this. If we're running low on stamina, we can just pop on over to aiming mode and we stop losing stamina. Kind of a nice little hint. I don't know how much it will help you because you can't move while doing that. You can transition from, you know, vine to vine or hookshot target. Hookshot target to hookshot target. But if you're climbing on vines, it's not a jelly blob? That wasn't even a reward at all. Why is there a bomb here? I don't even know. Oh, and we're full up, so who cares? There's some ladybugs over there, but as we've learned, bugs aren't too super important. And I actually wanted to get out my adventure pouch. I guess we don't need the stamina potion, so let's just go ahead and chug. And then we can go ahead and... Oh, did we get multiple servings of... Okay, cool. We don't get multiple servings of stamina potions, just showing that we have the effects of a stamina potion. I should probably fill up our other bottles with water, because we're probably going to need a few instances of it. But I don't really want to dump out my revitalizing potion and my fairy if I don't have to. So we'll just continue onwards. Because either this area is designed for, hey, you have to keep running back, or they just want us to dump out our, he did a little happy shuffle. Oh, and his walking animation is very, very cute. They totally expect us to just go either fill up a lot of bottles of water, or to just keep adventuring back and forth, which isn't great. Because you can do this by being patient, or you can do this by just getting rid of the... What the hell is this? Is this just a spot where a magma could come out, I'm guessing? That's what I'm guessing, that perhaps a magma could be there, but the magma's not ready to be there. I guess it's irrelevant, because we're just going to go ahead and make the goddess statue. God, I keep calling it goddess statues, but these are gossip statues. Because the goddess statues are the statues that look like the goddess. Whereas this is just something that's going to give us some garbage crafting material we don't really need any more of. Just like that other one, like a jelly blob? Seriously? Like, I get that perhaps, like... giving us a, oh hey, this is actually just slightly out of range, so we're going to have to come at it from a different angle, and or, Perhaps. Yeah, we're gonna just have to come at it from a different angle. Damn it, I was hoping that there'd be like some kind of like, here's some water and you don't have to go all the way back. It's kind of mean that they're gonna make us go all the way back. Yeah, because you can either solve this by being patient and just constantly trekking back and forth, and you know what, I'm gonna go ahead and just catch this. Why not? Even though I was just saying, oh, I'm too good to catch bugs, just because we don't really see the Eldin rollers very often. I think this is only like the second one we've ever seen, so might as well catch it. Why the? Oh, we've apparently seen three. That's fine, that's fine. Yeah, shoot, I suppose maybe I should just dump out my fairy and then bring two sets of water over here, just so we'll be fine. I kind of hate to lose the fairy, but I'd rather dump the... Well, actually, I don't think we're ever going to need the stamina potion ever again, really, because it's like... Our shield auto-fixes itself. It's not like it's going to... Well, I mean, it could potentially break, but I'd have to be doing very, very bad for it to break. But at the point where it's, like, about to break, I'd probably just call it, like... I'd probably... Well, not call it quits, but call it quits on, like, the defending and get super dodge-heavy. I suppose I could potentially also carry around a second shield to switch to whenever our shield got mad messed up, because it's like we have the space. In fact, we have a open... Oh, no, we don't have an open slot. Oh, no, we do have an open slot. That's what that was in the corner. Oh, excuse me. We have an open slot in our adventure pouch. I might as well as, like, carry around a second shield. I mean, why the hell not? I mean, that's going to be irrelevant eventually, but for now, it's still important. The stamina potion, I believe, lasts for 3 minutes. Which is, it's fine, you know, whatever. For 3 minutes, you get more stamina. It doesn't, like, really break the game in any way. It kind of just helps if, I guess, you're lazy and don't like to not run around. Which I feel like maybe they could have fixed by... Well, I was gonna say, like, having stamina, like, regen a little bit faster outside of combat. But I suppose, like, a lot of the reasons why stamina is in place for outside of combat areas. Like, oh, hey, you're running up this hill or, you know, trying to climb a thing. They're just here as a... mechanic to make you think or whatever the hell. Shoot, actually wait, this is gonna be the dungeon, isn't it? We gotta find a way above. Oh, what is that up there? That's just an open window or something. I love that he calls me bud. Yep, we're definitely off the map here. Something super important. Yeah, where are we gonna find it? He's so into goddess cubes though. The big actually it's kind of... All I can say is that's a big frog with a big oh my god. Yep, and one of our little bottles won't do it. We don't have a big container. Oh, shoot. Do we actually have to do... I think I remember what we have to do here, and this is a little weird, and I think if we ask Fi for help, she's just going to give us the hint of what we're supposed to do here, just in case you don't, like... The hell is... Oh, it's telling me my stamina potion's running out, which is very annoying, a very obnoxious beep. I wish it wasn't... that loud, but, you know, whatever. In fact, well, it's not a matter of how loud it is. What's bothering me more is how frequent the beep was, especially now that we're really, really running out. Can we see any vines out this window that we can hookshot onto? Because there was a area out there that we could, lots of vines and stuff we could hookshot on. Doing a lot of exploring this episode. Okay, we've only hit the hour mark. I was, like, kind of concerned about how long this episode could potentially be. We seem to be nearing the end of the area. I'm not sure how much more exploring we're going to have to do. Like, they're... Oop! He totally just chumped me! He's like, nope, none of that today. Because, like, obviously, if he does that little spin attack, he's got the momentum to carry him through the attack. He's already attacked at that point. Let's just go ahead and punish, and whack, and whack, and whack. Oh, he got away from that last whack. In fact, I thought the last whack would do it, and, oh man, we're the ones to knock him off this time. Beans. I suppose we aren't really in desperate need of his tail, because we have enough tails for the rest of the game. We're going to be seeing plenty of those guys in the next area, I believe, because they're typically a fire enemy. We're going into the fireplace, and I think that there's, like, the, like, those are Lizalfos. I believe that there's the Dinalfos equivalent that we haven't seen yet that, Wait, no, those guys breathe fire too, don't they? I was going to say that the Dinalfos breathe fire, but in this game, the Lizalfos also breathe fire, which is interesting, because normally that's the Dinalfos upgrade, or at least that's what I assume that the Dinalfos... Okay, we did actually get that. So we need to leave and go get a large container of water, which, if I remember the solution to this puzzle, is very, very silly. And I thought I got away from him that time. I kind of saw him snap onto us there, but, you know, whatever. I'm not too upset. I don't think he damaged us. I think we were already missing a heart and a... Actually, what is up with this area? Because if you look at this, it looks like there should be treasure here. Do we just have to kill, like, all the slimes? Is it just, like, a slime-killing party? Can I blow out the fire here? Actually, I don't know if we can blow out the fire. Yeah, we can blow out the fire for momentarily, but it comes back. Yeah, because that looks like there should be a treasure chest there. I don't have, like, a map, so I can't, like, you know, check if there's... I mean, we have a map, but we don't have, like, a dungeon map. Is there, like, a switch I gotta hit or something around here? Because it definitely looks like there should be, like, a treasure chest there. I don't really see, like, a thing that we could do. Like, I mean, we could kill these spooms and try and kill all the monsters in the area, but that doesn't sound too interesting to do. So I'm going to give the game the benefit of the doubt and assume that's not the puzzle here. Not that, like, you know, Zelda games have ever not had, like, just kill all the monsters in the room to solve the puzzle. And not even, like, dissing, kill all the enemies to continue, because that's a legitimate, like, gameplay thingamajig, whatever. I guess this scenario we'll come and explore later. Oh, hey, that's a goddess. Goddess whatever. Goddess box. That's what those are typically called. I don't want to lock onto that guy. Maybe this is part of... Actually, I wonder if this is an area we'll come and explore later in the game, or if this is part of the next dungeon. Next dungeon? Next dungeon as in the dungeon we're about to go to, not like... Oh boy, I'm tired. well, I guess not I, but our boy, Lonky-poo. Oh, that's straight in the magma, isn't it? Yep, that was straight in the magma. I want to get to a bird statue and get out of here. I know that there's the one, like, to the right of us, like, right... To the right behind us, I should say, would be more accurate. But that one's indoors, and I think it's only the ones outdoors that we can fly to, since, you know, they make a big burst of air that knocks us up. And this was the wrong exit. There's no bird statue in this direction. Oh, wait, there's a magma there. There was not a magma here previously. What's up, magma? Mm-hmm. Still looking for a friend. Hunt for treasure. If you had a thing, you want to know what's up? Mm-hmm. Flyer. Oh, is he just... Well, wait, what's the deal with this? Oh, okay. This is just a hint for if you haven't figured it out yet, because maybe Fi doesn't tell you. I saw Fi's thing go... Oh, no, yeah, now Fi's definitely just going to... Yep. So before, Fi just must have been like, oh, we need water. Maybe we should go ask the locals about water or something in the area. So I suppose that would have led us to this magma. For the love of God, don't do that. I already know what we're supposed to go get. I don't need the dowels. I get that you're very proud of your upgrade and being able to dowels. You're very excited to use this new feature you were bestowed by the goddess. Because you're like, yeah, I'm more than a sword. I can help you discover things via dowsing. A mechanic that you surely love and don't think is just a little obnoxious. It's better than the harp, though. I mean, the goddess bestowed you that harp. You appreciate the harp, right? Like, you love the harp? Like, actually, I'm going to talk to Fi here. Maybe she'll say the thing. Oh, yeah, she'll just say, I detect no water. Mm-hmm. Large basin of water. It's nice that Fi doesn't just immediately spill the beans and be like, hey, do you remember Lake Floria? There's a lot of water there, and I think that there's somebody who even had a big pot that you could put water in. Did you think about that? Because I did. Me. Fi. Definitely not just a mouthpiece for an over-coddling game developer or anything. God, I wonder who was the coddler when it comes to the game development thing for this. Because, like, I want to say it's Miyamoto, but I don't know how hands-on Miyamoto is with these projects. And it could be Anuma, but I honestly don't know enough about Anuma to say whether he's the coddly type or not. Like, I think it was Anuma that had the auto-jump feature built into Ocarina of Time because he said that he, like, sucks at platforming games. So I'm not sure. Like, it seems like a very Miyamoto thing. It could just be, like, an overall Nintendo attitude, which makes me very excited to see them kind of going back on that and maybe getting back to, like, their roots of, like, we're going to signpost a thing properly, like, fucking game developers and make our game, like, you know, kind of challenging but still string you along in the way that we help you, like a game's supposed to be, as opposed to having, like, you know, the mouthpiece for the game developers come out and say, hey, here's the solution to the puzzle just in case you didn't figure it out. Because it's like, I mean, I think it's nice to have those things included in games because it's like, otherwise people are just going to look up the problem. In fact, even with these kinds of things installed in games, people are very, actually, I don't want to go to Lake Floria. That's Floria Waterfall. I think that'd be closer to the Water Dragon. Maybe Lake Floria was closer, but oh well. We'll find out, because I think if we just turn around here, we can just get to where we're going. And in fact, actually, it's a good thing I came out here, because there were some vines that we couldn't get to previously that we can totally... And I don't want my bow, I want my hookshot. Claw shots, excuse me. Double claw shots, not double hookshots. We haven't had double hookshots yet in the Legend of Zelda series. Looking forward to that. But I don't know. I'm super excited for Breath of the Wild to maybe be a bit more like that, since that is what they've said, where it's like, hey, we're really going to respect our players' intelligence and kind of do the damn game design thing again. Because it's not like... Excuse me, I shouldn't say that, because this game is designed in, you know, a very player-friendly way. Let's, like, you know, teach them how to do things. They don't just, like, you're not just thrown into a place without really knowing what you should do. And actually, I'm going to go back up there, because I think I saw a thing that I was interested in. You know, puzzles are signposted, and there's ways to solve them without having hints. And it's very nice, but then the game just, you know, loads you up on, you know, Fi just kind of talking your ear off. And what is that over there? I don't really have a way to look any closer, but that means there should be a way to get over there, right? I don't see anything that we could hookshot onto. Very interesting. Maybe it's, maybe it's, like, just some grass that's supposed to look cool, but and I'm thinking it looks like rupees? I don't know. I don't see a way up there, though, so whatever. Well, I'm not too concerned. Yeah, this is just right behind the water dragon, so this was even closer than the Lake Floria one, I think. What is that down there? Oh, it's one of the Floridans. Florians, what were they called? I don't remember what they were called. They had a real weird name. I remember the one that we could talk to was like Jellyf. Oh, and they're not right here. I was hoping they were right here so I could just like lock on and find out what the race name was. Because we can't. Fi doesn't work underwater. Oh, is he leading like little? Or excuse me. I think Jellyf is a girl actually. But she's leading a little like school of them. That's very cute. Can we lock on to them when they're underwater? Nope. So their race name will continue to be unknown to me. Protozoras. Who cares? Yo, water dragon, I need this to make a frog not thirsty. Yep, there's 85% chance it'll work. Yep, it's a lot of water. It's a lot of water. Hopefully she'll let us use it. But I don't know, like, because this game is designed well, it does have, like, all the things, and it just has the mouthpiece for the developers. And I do think having the little hint system in place in the game is a useful, important, Yep, we're gonna call down Scrapper. Please call him. I should have said not that guy. Damn it, I didn't read. I was just like, I don't want to say the no option because, you know, that'll just make this take longer. But I honestly wish I would have checked not that guy to see what would have happened. It's useful to have hints in games just so players don't have to, like, look them up. Because if you look them up, you can be spoiled or learn more than you want. Sometimes it can be difficult to look up. And having a hint system in place is very useful. But I wish, you know, it was a bit more... player driven, like you know, a lot of the time you have to choose to talk to Fi, like we had to back at the next temple, but that isn't always the case. A lot of the time Fi will pop out and go, you know, I've set your new dowsing location, also the solution to puzzle is blank, which is very, very annoying. I feel like they could have done a little bit of a better job with that. I don't know if there's going to be a psychic character to Breath of the Wild. I'm kind of hoping there isn't. It'd be nice to see a 3D Zelda sans, like, where Sans from Undertale is the, no, you know, Sans a sidekick. That'd be very interesting. Like, I know we have our Sheikah Slate, and from the trailers, we know that, like, maybe you get, like, telepathically talked to, but I don't know how frequent that'll be. Hopefully that's not too frequent, though. That'd be nice. Because, you know, the psychic character was, like, a nice conceit for, like, the whole, like, Z-targeting system. Since that was kind of a new interesting thing, that like a new interesting mechanic that wouldn't really make sense to people, especially since like 3D games were new at the time. Like, you know, the 3D space was still a very experimental thing, and having this kind of character be like the explanation for how this works was a good idea and also kind of a bad one, because then all of a sudden this weird abstract concept has, you know, a face to it. I can go, oh yes, Navi flies over there and it helps me lock onto things. I get it. But then also it's like, you know, you don't really have to struggle with the abstract thought of it. Like, what is actually happening here? I don't know if that's really a problem. Actually, I think I just pulled that on my ass. That's not really this thing. Who cares? I'm excited for Breath of the Wild. That's where that was going. We have less than a week to beat this game. I think we'll do it, though. Let's just get to where we need to go so we can... Oh, yeah, I was like, so we can go and do the dungeon next, but hoo boy, do I actually need a small break before I do the dungeon. So that'll be in the next episode for you guys, maybe like in an hour for me. I guess we'll see how I'm feeling because, oh my god, my... Wait, what's happening here? Oh god, is something bad gonna happen? Yeah, he's rushing ahead. I think something bad happens here now that I think about it. He's probably gonna land somewhere weird, and this episode isn't over just yet. We're gonna have a little bit more conflict, I'm thinking. Yep, especially since they threw us over here. I'm thinking maybe the thing I thought happened later happens now. So, hoo boy, we might have more episode to go. Oh god, I was about to say, my shoulders are killing me. Oh, god. You almost blew a rotor trying to slow myself down. I don't know why that tickled me, though, as much as it did. This is not where I wanted the water. What, the summit? What? Oh, Scrapper, I love you. I love you lots. Yep, I'm thinking the thing that I thought happened later happens now. This area is loaded with bokoblins? Bokoblins? Not really sure what the right pronunciation is. Yep, a lot of monsters around here. I bust up enemies like a junkyard wrecker! Too bad I've got my mitts full. Aw, yeah, don't worry. We'll take care of them. Master Shortpants will do this. Let's play a little game called... Oh, good Christ! I forgot that this was a... Oh no, I thought this would be a different thing. This is an escort mission. Oh Jesus, this is gonna be bad. Okay, so I was thinking that we'd only have to explore this area like on foot, like trek through it one more time, but that was incorrect. I'm gonna go ahead and counter snipe this guy. He hit me, which is fine because I can take the heat. Scrapper cannot because he's like, I don't want to get hit one time, so I should also probably be strafing while doing this, so I don't get hit. I mean, I'd rather him hit me than, I don't think these pea hats will present a problem. But yeah, now we're gonna have to, we just explored through this area, since we had to, you know, find the trial gate, and then we did the Silent Realm, and we're already having to almost entirely re-explore this area. Like, they're giving us a nice little shortcut here, or at least I'm assuming this is a shortcut, since there's pea hats kind of signposting us across. Am I getting too far ahead, or is that just like a... Nope, I am. I'm right there. And I hear Bokoblins, and I want to get moving so he doesn't get shot at. Yeah, he's saying that multiple times, so I'm guessing that's a, hey, you've gotten too far from me, but, oh, I need to press A to let go. Which way do we need to go to continue onwards? I think this way, because we have that little shortcut that we made, and let's get out our bow. Because I have no idea how aggressive these Bokoblins will become towards Scrapper. And I don't know how many hits Scrapper can really take, since there's not, like, really a health bar on screen. And the only consideration I have to go is, he said, not one single claw. And that was actually kind of a dangerous jump there. These guys over here, I don't know how much vision they have, but let's go ahead and just take them out since we can go ahead and hit them pretty easily. And, oh, that's a pea hat over there. Is this area locked off? Like, there's this Moblin in our way. I don't know how much trouble the Moblin will be for Scrapper. But as long as like Scrapper doesn't get in the way, I can just deal with this guy, because we already know we can just slice up his shield. And I always forget he has that shield bash that actually hurts us. I'm so used to shield bashes being like a. What are you doing? He has a little shoot alarm that goes off when the monster gets close, and that's very cute. I wonder. Okay, cool. That doesn't set us too far back. Is that alarm just gonna keep going off? Where are you? All right, Scrapper, you just wait right here. I'm gonna deal with this guy. Yeah, there we go. That took care of him, no problem. That's actually a pretty good strategy. I should do that in the future. We can just, once we get rid of their shield, we can unload into them. I mean, I guess nothing's stopping us from doing that with, they have their shield up as well, actually. We can just totally just go to town on them. And I hear keys, but I don't see them. There they are. Oh, and these are cursed keys. Interesting. I believe that we saw them in the, beneath the ancient cistern. I don't really remember if they were cursed keys down there, but I'm just going to go ahead and make the assumption. Because, you know, making assumptions is good. That's how that saying goes, is you should always make as many assumptions as you can, because it makes your life easier, and you have to do a little bit less thinking that way. I'm pretty sure how that statement goes. Let's go ahead and take these guys out. Man, that guy rolled pretty far. I'm surprised I'm making these shots. It looks like I'm slightly missing, but there might be a little bit of, variation. Not variation, deterrence? Shoot, what is the word I am looking for? There's a physics phrase I'm trying to think of that I can't think of. Oh, shoot, I'm gonna shoot the bomb. That's gonna be sick. Yeah, awesome. That kind of shit's really cool. Let's go ahead and take care of this Bokoblin so he doesn't, like, look up. Yep, he even looked up when his friend came tumbling down. I think we're Bokoblin free now. I don't know, like, this isn't too bad, but just the fact that we have to basically re-explore the entirety of this area two times in a row is kind of a pain. If they had spread it out, maybe it'd be a bit more interesting if they had us traverse through this area in a different way than we had previously, but this is pretty much just the same thing we just did. Let's go ahead and go for that headshot. I don't know if that's any extra damage in this game, and he's like, what the hell just happened? Oh, shoot, it's two. Oh, for a second, I thought he was going into his dying animation. I was like, really? Just two fully charged arrows is enough to kill a moblin? No, three arrows. That's very impressive. That's a good way to deal with those guys. Makes you think about how many things they consider you doing in, like, these kinds of games. Like, because obviously, you know, all the enemies are designed around sword combat. And, like, Dark Souls has the same problem where they are, like, they consider for, like, you know, different kinds of characters. The games can be played, like, you know, in, like, almost infinite amount of ways. But it's, like, the games are basically balanced for, melee combat and melee combat alone, pretty much. Like, in terms of how they expect you to, well, expect you, I'll put in quotation marks, to handle encounters. And then if you come in with, like, a bow, you can kind of snipe enemies and kind of chump things a little bit. If you're patient enough or, you know, willing to give it the cheese enough, or you're just ticked off by how annoying a situation in Dark Souls 2 can be enough, which Bloodborne kind of fixes, but, I mean, that's a different game, that's not what we're here to talk about, and I cannot make that shot, so we'll just go ahead and continue up to the next area before we start sniping these guys so they leave our good robot friend alone. Oh, hey, there's moblins up here I couldn't see, hopefully. Oh, nope, he is over there. No, please don't hit my friend. Okay, cool, once we got over here, he was less interested in Scrapper. It's nice that they're more interested in killing us than they are killing Scrapper, because that tends to be a big problem with escort missions, where it's like, you know, the enemies are suddenly very, very interested in killing your friend as opposed to going after you. So it's nice that the moblins prioritize us over Scrapper, because otherwise, I don't know how far that would have set us back by him getting hit. I doubt it would have been, like, go back to the beginning, you let your friend get hit once, but it would have been a shame, also, because it would have stopped our perfect record that we have going through here thus far. Any moblins wanna dance up here? Nope, no moblins want to dance. Oh, I hear Bokoblin. Where are you, Bokoblin? I heard it. Oh, there you are. I'm just gonna run over here and give you the spicy sword. The good spicy sword. I do need some more arrows. Oh, hey, they're blue Bokoblins. He tried to give me that jump attack, but I'm the master of jump attacks. Like, that is like Link's thing. Like I'm talking about Link as the Nintendo trademark character, not good Lonk here. Lonk's such a good boy, and he would never give a jump attack and stab a thing into someone's skull unnecessarily. He would only do it if necessary, or if he was feeling it, depending on, like, what kind of character I'm trying to sell here. I'm not really sure what I'm doing here. Oh, he has more health than the other ones, which makes a lot of sense. Back up, my dude. He needs my last arrow right in his face. Well, I've whiffed it. That's fine, because these guys are pretty easy to kill. We just run at him, he puts a shield up, we hop behind him, and now we can give him the spicy sword, which he should be low in health. And hopefully him falling doesn't hurt. Okay, cool. It doesn't hurt Scrapper. I would appreciate arrows over rupees, but whatever. Hopefully something will have the decency to drop some arrows. No cursed keys up here? I figured there'd be some, because there's normally some keys in this hallway. Oh, shoot, there's archers. I could use some arrows. Please be arrows in this hole. Please be arrows in this hole. There's not going to be arrows in this hole. And I don't think we can pick up flaming arrows. I guess we're just going to have to make do. I'll just go ahead and take out this moblin, see what happens. Hopefully the, I want to call them snipers, but the archers don't just deal with him. And oh, cool, we've gotten him in the, like, we're just totally strafing around in him, stabbing as he tries to turn. He can't figure it out. Oh, yep, they've been counter-sniping him this entire time. Oh, I swear to God, do we have to go down to the bottom? Please don't make us go back to the bottom. I was out of arrows. There's nothing I could... Well, I suppose I could have gone after them first. I recommend repairing it and trying again. How? Okay, I'm back at the area where we killed. I have a single arrow that I think I might have picked up when these guys were shooting at us. Perhaps I missed an arrow and we can pick them up. I'm not sure if we can or not with the flaming arrows. Was it only that one sniper, or are there multiple? Yeah, there's another archer up there who I'm going to have to deal with. I unfortunately didn't pick up any arrows at all. Hopefully he'll just shoot some and whiff some shots and maybe we can pick them up. Yeah, cool, we can pick up Flaming Arrow. So I'm just going to sit here and pick up some arrows so we can deal with his friend, because as long as he shoots at us, it's not a problem. Actually, I'm probably going to have to kill him before I shoot at his friend. You know, we'll just deal with four arrows because I don't want to spend forever trying to counter-snipe him, but I don't want to spend forever trying to build up my arrows. Let's go ahead and deal with his friend. Hopefully we won't activate the Moblin. Because the second we aggro the Moblin... I mean, I guess if he comes and whacks us, it's not too much of a problem, but if he went after Scrapper, it could be the end of the game, as it were. Coming back up here, I realized I had made a mistake the first time we were exploring through here, because I could have totally taken a shortcut I had opened that was in between the... that would have let us skip like the first little area that we went through. Because there was like a wall we blew up very early in the game that would have allowed us to just skip just a little bit of the area we explored. I don't think there's too many shortcuts that I missed. So I think majority of like the shortcut thingies are very actually, is that the... Yeah, we took a shortcut the first way going through that led us to that like first Moblin that we fought. But you could have skipped that entire area and gone to the slope that we ran up. Not the slide, but the slope that we ran up. The first slope you run up, I should say, because there's multiple slopes you run up. And I'm kind of got stuck in them, but that's fine, because that's not going to mess up anything. We're just going to take a little bit of damage. Maybe we can even collect that 20 rupees before it despawns. So we could have taken that shortcut and saved a little bit of time. It's not a huge time saver. But, you know, it's whatever. And I've tried digging in every hole I saw, and I tried cutting down all the grass I saw, but unfortunately I was gifted no arrows. I think to acquire arrows, I'm probably going to have to do proper combat with maybe some Bokoblins. Maybe they'll drop some more arrows, because we totally ran out of arrows. I chumped too many of them with the bow, and then was put into a bad, bad place. Luckily, it doesn't matter how many stupid quiche there are, because as long as they're interested in me, they won't go after Scrapper. So we just have to stick close to Scrapper, and it's all gun BK. We'll just run up here, and I think this will let us kind of take a short way around. There doesn't seem to be any... doesn't seem to be any Bokoblins in here, but they've replaced, you know, Bokoblins with Lizalfos as the enemies. So as long as we can keep them off Scrapper, you know, it doesn't really matter. We'll deal with them just fine. So we just have to stay close enough to Scrapper that they don't become a problem. What I'm actually really worried about is the Spoom, because I don't know if the Spoom's going to... Yeah, they're firing at our boy. Just put a bomb down, just to kind of make him back up. I wish Scrapper was a little bit more intelligent, because if he would just hang back just a little bit, we could deal with this combat encounter, wouldn't have any problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get close enough that hopefully the Spoom will fire on me. Unfortunately, I got out of range for this Lizalfos, and he decided to go to town on him. Because I want to keep the Spoom and the Lizalfos entertained, because if we were to lose here, that would be a super shame, since the frickin', we'd have to make the entire trek back here again. I mean, I suppose I can edit it out for you just like I did previously. But I'm still going to have to make the trip here, which would really suck. Let's go ahead and get these guys' attention. I'm going to throw bombs at them because I don't want them attacking Scrapper. They can go to town on me, but Scrapper, that'll be a problem because I have a lot of health. I'm not sure how much health Scrapper has, and he's already kind of taken a little bit of a beating. And there's this last little giant fire... Oh, is he not going to spawn? Okay, I guess he's not going to spawn. Cool, cool, cool. I was waiting for that fire choo-choo to spawn and be our last trial. I mean, I guess I can't for certain say that this area is safe sailing, but I don't... there wasn't anything here the first time. There's nothing appeared on this bridge. In fact, I see Gorko just chilling over there, so we're safe. We've made it. We're good. Boy, I was so prematurely like, oh yeah, this episode's over. We can just chill. But nope, we had to explore the entirety of the volcano again. Like, we could have shaved off, like, a few minutes. Like, maybe, like... 3-4 minutes of that had I realized that I could have taken that shortcut instead of just assuming it was blocked off to me. Because I even shot a Bokoblin that was like kind of protecting that area. I just didn't consider going that way for whatever stupid reason. But hey, it all worked out. We explored this area. This kind of segment, I guess, gave a little bit of weight to my complaint of like having to explore through Eldin a few too many times. And there's not real much to variance to it. Like, when I saw those pea hats kind of leading me ahead, I was like, oh, shoot, like, you know, there's going to be a lot, like, to kind of vary this. Like, I bet they're going to put a lot of, like, interesting, like, enemy encounters and, you know, have a lot of interesting shortcuts using these pea hats, perhaps. But that was not the case. It was just kind of, let's throw bokoblins everywhere and see what happens. Those cursed keys at the beginning were super strange, too. Why the hell were they here? Just to, like, really mix it up? Like, what's the deal? Are the, like, the cursed keys, like, considered a part of, like, Girahim's army that he can control or whatever? Like, that's just kind of strange because they seem, like, you know, keys seem very beast-like. Not saying that, I guess, the Bokoblin and Moblins aren't very beast-like, but, you know, they seem, they're more humanoid, so it's not, like, out of the picture to, like, imagine that they can be controlled. But, you know, whatever. I'm worrying about, like, what the lore too much. What's important is that area was kind of a pain. We're Silent Realm thus far, but we have you know, dungeon next time, and I love dungeons. So, next time, Fire Sanctuary, I believe this is called? I think it's the Fire Sanctuary. Might be just the Fire Temple again. Anyways, I'll see you next time for that.